travel advisor was extremely helpful and put my wife at ease right away by answering all the little queries that bother a family putting to sea for the first time. What clothes should we take? How should we set about booking a hotel in Melbourne? And what was the best way of getting from Melbourne to Brisbane? Could we buy this, that, and the other on board? Or should we bring it? We needn't have worried. Everything seemed to have been thought of from the very start of our journey. In fact, from the moment we joined the boat train at Waterloo, we discovered that service was the keynote. Everything was so amazingly simple and well organized. The ORCADES was waiting to greet us at Southampton at the end of our brief train journey. As soon as you get your first glimpse of an Orient liner, you feel the calm and efficient air that characterizes both the ship and her company. You sense the confidence of men who know exactly what they're doing and enjoy doing it anyway. You sense, too, the atmosphere of welcome that is nonetheless genuine for being well organized. Perhaps, again, it's something to do with the fact that people who take pride and pleasure in their own jobs are usually the friendliest and most courteous. I'm not a VIP, but on the day I boarded the ORCADES, I felt like one, and I think every other passenger felt the same way. The steward who showed us our cabin explained that our cabin baggage was all waiting for us and our heavy things were in the hold, except for the ones we'd marked wanted, and they could be brought along any time we needed them. What about that parcel I'd sent to the ship? It wasn't in the cabin. A purchase tax parcel? Oh, that would be issued soon after the ship sailed, but meanwhile I could check that it had arrived at the purser's office if I wished. Lunch would be served in half an hour, which gave us comfortable time to do a little unpacking. The cabin was beginning to feel like home already. I wondered how many different types the steward had shown into it on other trips. The charming and the not-so-charming. The good-tempered and the not-so-good-tempered. The brisk and the fussy. For it's the privilege of the passenger to be any of these things. But from the very start of the voyage, the ship's company know they can't be bad-tempered or brisk or fussy. They have aboard a varied selection of human beings who will be all the things that human beings are, namely everything in the book. But that Blue Peter coming down means, for the next few weeks, this is a self-contained community, and it's going to be a happy one. Otherwise, the ship's company will have failed in their job, and they've never done that yet, not on the Orient Line.